Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English, books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese, with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. Having meditation centers in 151 countries including Bidadi, Thiruvannamalai, Rajapalayam, Salem, Hyderabad, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio, Seattle, San Jose and Phoenix. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation. A contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers. Adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, he has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands, gracing them with spiritual powers. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples worldwide in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places like Bangalore, Hyderabad and Thiruvannamalai in India. A dynamic young guru who is an inspiration to thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
Nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyana loka pradipakam, vande shantamayam bandham, nityanandaya swagatam, ananda gandha sancharam, sarvopadhi vinirmuktam, vande jnanalayam natham, nityanandaya swagatam.
How to forget ex-boyfriend? Please understand, by catching another on man, you will never be able to forget the ex-man who was in your life. Don't think 3.5 billion men are there. At least 2.5 billion are youth. You can choose from anyone. Why do you want to struggle with the old rotten apple? You have a lot of choice. These are all foolish misguidance. Don't be misguided. I tell you, unless you find the man inside you, unless a woman finds a man inside her, man finds a woman inside her, you can't rest in peace. You can't forget your X or Y or Z. What do you mean? How to forget? Try however much to forget. The more you try to forget, the more you are going to remember. One fellow went to a Guruji asking, can I have some Kundalini awakening? That poor Guruji doesn't know anything except little Ayurveda, gives him a Kundalini Kashayam and tells, drink this, your Kundalini will be awakened. But you have to drink without remembering the monkey. This fellow goes, and you know what would have happened? The first question this guy asks, all right, if I remember, what should I do? The Guruji says, very simple, take bath once. The guy goes, he's about to drink the medicine. Naturally, he remembers monkey because he's told not to remember. The moment he remembered the monkey, he thought, oh, now what should I do? Take bath. He runs, takes bath, comes back to the room again, picks up the bottle again. I'm not supposed to remember something. What is that? What is it? Oh, monkey. Oh, already I remembered. He runs to the bathroom, takes bath, comes back. Again he remembers the monkey. In 2 hours he's just jumping from bathroom to room, bathroom to room, bathroom to room. Literally like a monkey. In half a day, he is completely tired. He sees everywhere monkey. He is hallucinating. Monkeys everywhere. He runs, throws that medicine on that Guruji and tells, enough your impractical suggestions, solutions, answers. Now I am mad with the monkey. Please leave me. He runs away. If you are misguided by this kind of solutions, foolish ideas, this is where you land. I tell you, please understand, in the world, there may be 3.5 billion men and 2.5 billion are youth, whatever. But unless you find the man inside, means unless you experience the completion inside, please understand, each man carries certain feminine principles and energy inside. Each woman carries certain masculine principles and energy inside. Only when the inside energies are met and merged, fulfillment happens. Only then you can forget your X, Y chromosomes and relax in Z. Z means zest. Understand, how many men you may change externally, you will not find a solution. Changing external men or women and trying to find a solution is a Western method. Once in 3 months, house, car and husband. If you don't change, you are not updated. How long this can go on? I tell you, oh next gen, don't listen to these foolish advices. Don't be misguided. Don't think changing outside is anyway going to bring any solution. Look in. The solution is within. Find the source of your fantasies. Find the root why your boyfriend has become ex-boyfriend. Because he is not fitting with your inner idea of boyfriend. In your innermost fantasies, secret corners of your mind, the fantasy, the idea, the visualization you carry about a boyfriend did not fit with your boyfriend. That is why he became ex. Unless you work on that fantasy and learn to accept and settle down with the reality, you are not going to relax at any moment. You may catch new boyfriend to forget ex-boyfriend. Again, you will be forced to catch another one boy to forget this boy. This is the way the Western society lost stability. 90% of the problems of the Western society is not because of their Please understand, 90% of the problems of the Western society is just because there is no stability in their social system. Stable family can solve millions of our problems. I don't know how these foolish psychiatrists and low-minded so-called leaders give this kind of advice to you. Catch another one. Choose another one. You can forget the ex. What kind of an advice? I tell you, look in. Go to the root of the fantasy. Unless you correct the fantasy and accept the real person in your life, you are never going to settle down. As long as the fantasy is there as it is, how many person you may change? You may change once in 3 months or once in a month, even once in a week. You are not going to be experiencing peace. You will only be having the feeling of X, 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 X. That's all.
Just an hour's drive from Bangalore, Asia's fastest growing city, is a unique space of healing, meditation and rejuvenation. Welcome to Nityananda Dhyanapeetam. Experience soothing, healing energies under the ancient wish-fulfilling banyan tree in the presence of divinity. Enjoy the unique anti-aging formula of the original Siddha Healing Spa with the 21-foot energized healing lingam and healing pool, the Vaidya Sarovar. Connect directly to God in the vibrant silence of Nityanandeshwara Temple. Savor the delicious sattvic food served free at all times. Best of all, get a glimpse of authentic spiritual life at the daily morning satsang, worship, yoga and meditation sessions with Paramahamsa Nityananda. Rediscover yourself at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, the ultimate spiritual lifestyle destination. Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311. Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
The second question you asked, how to curb desire to watch porn? This is one of the worst problem modern youth is facing. Understand? No pranayama can help you. No yoga or meditation can help you unless you understand the root of this desire. Understand first, what is porn? It is nothing but trying to have something impossible. Means you have two hands, but suddenly trying to have four hands. I wanted to stop with hands. It is nothing but trying to be impractical. Please understand, porn takes away your real love, real lust, real romance, real passion in life. You think pornography increases your passion? No! It adds too much of fantasies, makes real life dull. Man who watches porno will always be in depression and carrying a guilt about his abilities. No buffalo, no bull, no dog, no donkey thinks about his performance. It is only human being suffer with this great disease of performance contributed by porno. I tell you, porn does not add love, lust, passion to your life. It only takes away. Whether you are a man or a woman, porn takes away reality from you. I have some of the statistics here. 2.5 billion emails per day which are pornographic are shared all over the world. 68 million a day search engine related requests for porn. Alright, I don't even want to look into the statistics, leave it. But unfortunately, human beings don't understand the way porn works on you. It doesn't enrich you, it makes you poor. You don't understand. Because you think it is enriching you, you are taking it. See, if you know, there is something which is poisonous for you, which will kill you slowly but surely. Will you eat or drink that? No! Because you think it enriches you, you go behind it. Porn is like that only. Because you think it enriches you go behind it. I tell you, porn takes away your love for reality. And one more thing I want to tell you. The real love or lust you carry in your body, if you live in your regular life, you will at least exhaust that and you will be free from it. You will be liberated. You will go beyond. There is no animal other than human being which can be involved in sex, interested in sex till death, even in the wheelchair. Only human beings are cursed. For every animal, there is a season, body reproduces and settles down. In human life, there is no settling period. Don't you see? There is no settling period. There is no end. Because of the new component introduced in your life called mind. Mind can store the pictures. Even ordinary pictures it can store. What about porn? I tell you, humanity without pornography will be violence free. When you are infused with so much of passionate desire and you can't live it up as you see in the visuals through your body, the whole passion gets converted into violence and gets stored in your body. Passion gets recorded as violence in your body. Humanity suffers with so much of violence, whether it is domestic or country. Both violences are just because of porn.
Want to get divine guidance for your life directly from an avatar? Introducing Dial the Avatar.
Nityanandam, Nityananda here.
Paramahamsa Nityananda gives yet another incomparable, unique gift for the whole world.
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
He has opened himself and is available
you
to answer questions from anyone.
Great.
Live during the daily morning satsang.
Now you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
Starting from 8 a.m., the lucky ones who dial 080-2727-9999. Get to talk directly with Swamiji. Watch all of this live at ntv.nityananda.org.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nityananda. Nityananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher-order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social-emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting, and design offered in the Ingenious Program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of all abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings. Understand, it is going to take away your joy, your love, your real life. It is going to make you plastic, pseudo. Only if you have this insight and understanding, you will be able to get out of this desire to watch porn. Unless you understand, no pranayama can help. No other technique can help. When porn is added to your mind and body, it leaves the natural realms and destroys the reality of your life. Life becomes hell. And neither you'll be satisfied with one man or one woman in your life. Then naturally, you'll have to make your boyfriend into ex-boyfriend and go to some psychiatrists or gurujis for advice, for you to understand the reality as reality. Once the porn gets mixed in your system, you will not have respect for the real person in your life. Your lust will always be having the guilt of impossibility. Your desire will always have the unfulfillment before even it starts. A continuous hangover of anger, guilt of inability. You will see how this destroys your beautiful life. Human being should take birth and grow with his natural flow without the interference of the mind. Should be physically matured at the age of 21, and next 14 years should do the job of reproducing, and by 21 to 35 should be his grihastha life. After that, he should be out of physical relationships. He should be ripe and become vanaprasthi. By next 14 years, he should be sannyasi. First three cycle, brahmacharya, means till 21 years, 777. Second two cycles, grihastha, till 35. Next two cycles, vanaprastha, means till 46, 49. Vanaprastha, by 50, you should be a sannyasi. This is the beautiful flowering for a natural ordinary human being. But unfortunately, when the porn component comes inside, even if you are sitting in the wheelchair, you can't keep quiet. It is so unfortunate. And I wanted to tell all the youth, next gen, please listen. The worst suffering you can have in your life is having the mind which is still jumping when the body is not able to jump. If you understand what I am saying. In the old age, when your body can't do anything, if your mind is jumping, that is hell. That happens just because of pornography. If you want to be in hell in your old age, you can add pornography to your body. Like if you constantly add alcohol and smoking, how you are going to have physical illness in the old age? If you add pornography, you are going to have mental illness in the old age. It's a simple decision of your health. I am not teaching from the angle of morality, enlightenment, spiritual science, no. I am just telling you plain health facts. Porn will make you sick while you are young and when you become old, in both the ways. Have this deep insight and it takes away the joy of the real persons in your life. The other day I was reading an article about how people have virtual farms. Means they get hen and then the egg and hatch, get chicken and then hen. Whole thing in Twitter, Facebook. The whole thing in Facebook. And they sell and buy. God. Happening. Castle in the air. Building the identity based on just ideas, emptiness. And it seems you even get a message, your fishes are dying, please come and feed them games. And by it becomes reality. I tell you, naturally human beings need something extra to cope up with reality. You can't build your identity and personality just on reality. You need something extra. Have deities for your entertainment, which will take you to enlightenment. That is why our ancestors said, I have Atmalinga, small deity for your own. Dress up, clean, bathe, live, feed, sleep, live with the deity. It is million times better than living with your virtual form. Here at least you are remembering higher concepts and led to higher life. Do you know the latest fast spreading mental disorder in US is Facebook syndrome. People get depressed. Youngsters, if they are not allowed to use Facebook for 24 hours, they get nervous breakdown. They start shivering. The only kriya for Facebook is Twitter/Sri Nityananda. 350 million people are suffering from Facebook addiction disorder. God. Do not bring too much of fantasies into your real life. Do not infuse too much of fantasies into your real life. Do you know millions of South Africans are suffering with this Facebook syndrome, Facebook addiction disorder? People who don't have food. That is what the other day somebody was telling me. In Indian villages, many of the houses, we don't have washrooms, but we have two cell phones. 2 cell phone, 2 TV, 1 mixer and grinder, and no washrooms. I know the modern day youth is really suffering. Humanity has never faced this crisis. I have created a 1-year program where you can study the spiritual truths.
Nitya yoga practices to create healthy body, spiritual discourses to develop mental health, meditations that help balance emotions, kriyas to break mental patterns that create suffering, opportunity to express leadership qualities, techniques that improve creative skills. Learn to break all self-limiting barriers to achieve your dreams. Ananda Yogam.
I am providing a platform for you to think, meditate, contemplate and decide about your future. I am giving you 1 year free food, shelter, clothes, above all the spiritual education and intelligence and intuition to take decision about your future.
Every participant is taught the Vedic truths to live life as it leads in a nurturing ambience, along with inspirational spiritual education that helps bring out the best and achieve one's highest potential.
Youth across the world can come and spend 1 year in Ananda Yogam to work on you, to discover your future, to discover your destiny or recreate your destiny. I'll open my house for you for 1 year completely free. Come and stay here, discover and recreate your destiny.
Interviews at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biddi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
The question is, I am gay, is it wrong? All human beings go through 4 stages. Please understand, 1, enjoying your own body. When you are a child, you put your own thumb in the mouth. Sometimes you even lift your leg and put the thumb in the mouth, playing with your own body, because taking direct jump to the opposite gender is too much. This period, trying to explore your same gender, that period only you call it as gay. Then you start exploring the opposite gender, that is heterosex. When you experience the whole cosmos with you, that is brahmacharya, ultimate enlightenment. What Ramakrishna says, I felt alive with every flower, tree, whole. That happens as the 4th stage. These are the 4 petals of Muladhara Chakra. Understand, I don't want to say anything is right or wrong, but I want to say these are the 4 different stages of life. Naturally, you need to evolve to the last stage, the ultimate stage, enlightenment, brahmacharya. Whether you go through these 3 stages and evolve, or without going through these 3, jump into the brahmacharya, is up to you. You can see the Muladhara Chakra. These are the four petals of the Muladhara Chakra. One is enjoying your own body, another one is enjoying same gender, third is enjoying the opposite gender, the fourth is enjoying the whole universe, Brahmacharya or Sannyasa. You have to reach the fourth. How you reach is up to you. There is nothing higher or lower. Not reaching the fourth, being stuck any other three is wrong. If you can reach the fourth, all three are right. If it does not allow you towards the fourth, all three are wrong. So, it is how you use this three and where you reach from this three that decides whether these three are right or wrong. Till then, we can't comment on it. We can't make any comment about it.